Hello, and welcome back to Insanity, where we are slowly progressing towards the green science. Last time we left off, we finished a very important step. We made laboratory instruments. So in this episode, we are going to start to craft these Halesias. Hopefully we will get some of them at least. The thing is that we need to create 3 times this recipe, which means that we will get 6 Halesias in total. The reason for this is that we need to make Halesia seeds so that we have something to plant, basically. At least that's what I believe. Yes, because a different way to get the Halesias is by using the seeds. And we need to... So we need to first get the seeds in order to start the production, and we need a minimum of 5 seeds. Which means that we need at least 5 Halesias, and the way we can get that is by performing this recipe 3 times. So we will start off by making a couple of more Halesia codex and a couple of flower DNA samples. And the flower DNA sample itself requires a Halesia codex. How great is that? So now we will be spending our 200 saved science that we have over here. We will, however, not stop the chest from being filled, because we believe that we will have use for it again. And then we will be making some Halesia codex, which means that we will need a whole lot of seaweed. A whole lot of seaweed, that's for sure. And also a bit of iron. Always some iron. There we go. So do we have one of them. So we need to create 2 more for the flower DNA samples, and then another set of 2 for the actual ingredients. Great! Now that's taken care of. We have 200 automation science packs. We have 1 flower DNA sample in our inventory already. So I think we need to start off by using this data array. Do I have a steel chest? I do not. We should of course have thought about that. Let's make 10 of them. And then more Halesia codex. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. 5. I think this will be correct. Data array, hello! Oh, beer DNA samples, B DNA samples, so many DNA samples. DNA sample all the things. What, our steel chest is not ready yet? Come on. Okay, so Halesia codex. Let's just wait for the Halesia codex so that we can start this process. Meanwhile, let's take a look at our Rauk production once again. Let's take a look at our Favogaius. We have a whole lot of them. And here we go, there is our steel chests. Great! Now we can actually put in the other Halesia codex here as well, because we are, as I said, going to need 3 of these flower DNA samples. And now we are crafting 3 other Halesia codex. Great! Biosamples. So we need 15 biosamples. How many do we have? Zero. Sure. I think we have a machine here that creates biosamples. It's very much far from being automated, but still. And it seems like it requires some more biocontainers. We can fix that. Biocontainers. Let's make all of them. And I think we will even need even more of them. Biocontainers. What are we missing? We're missing titanium plates. Let's grab us some titanium plates. Hello, bus. Thank you, bus. Great. Okay, now we have queued that up. Now for the horrible part. We need a gene lab, and then we need to get even more biosamples. We need moss gene samples, which I have a small feeling that we might have somewhere already. Moss gene sample. You know what? This is a perfect opportunity to use our search mod that just crashed. Great. Oops. That was not intended. Luckily, it seems like we didn't lose too much of our progress. I think. So, okay. Let's not use the search mod. I'll have to figure out the bug with the search mod. At least it wasn't a blue screen. Okay. Where were we? We need the moss gene sample. And for that, we need a gene lab. I think we should have that somewhere already. See how useful this search mod would be at the moment, if only it would be working. Incubator, biofactory, phytoplankton farm. It's not one of those. Automated factory, data array, Favgaia plantation, clay pits. Did I not make? Spore collector, Rauk paddock, moss farm, sap extractor, high pressure furnace. Sure, whatever, let's make a gene lab. Nixilite, titanium, iron, and copper. Nixilite, titanium, iron, and copper. That's the titanium. That's the iron. Let's go grab some nixilite, and hopefully we have still have a bit of copper in the chests. Let's see. Sadly, it's been a while since I worked on that search mod, so that's probably why it's not working. Apparently, I left it in a unfinished, untested stage or something. Very well. Either way, we should hopefully find the nixilite because at least that we know where it is. Oh, this is nice. We have plenty of nixilite here, even. So can we make a gene lab now? Yes, we can. Good, then I also believe we need something called an incubator. So while we are taking a look at things, at machines to make, we might as well take a look at that as well. So this can go on the, we know that we have Duralumin on our main bus. That's what I wanted to say. Somewhere. I can see it. Here it is. Great. And while we are in the area, let's take a look and see if we have gotten more. We have! We have 20 laboratory instruments now. Awesome! So let's make that incubator first of all. Great. Next up. That's assuming that we can make all the biosamples and all that. Now we come to the fun part. We need plasmids. And we need a biofactory for this. And I'm sure I have that as well somewhere. Biofactory. But just in case we can't find it, we will create one. So now we need to get some of this Sogna bacteria and stuff. So it would be reasonable to say that we should plan have this biofactory thing over here. Oh, here is a biofactory. Interesting. Do we have any more biocontainers? Biocontainers, here they are. Apparently there's something called a bioreactor as well. Cool. Let's make some more biocontainers. I have a feeling we might use them. Oh boy, this is going to take quite a bit of time to craft all these things, but we are slowly but surely getting there. A big reason for why it takes so long time is because we need to craft all the basic simple circuit boards. And the reason for why that is taking a long time is because we need to handcraft them, because we can't use the recipe, because we don't have the moon drop yet, which is what we are working on. Okay. Slowly but surely, I think we are getting there. In the meantime, let's take a look and see if we need something else, like basic substrate, incubated petri dish. That one especially might be a bit of a problem, because that's a process that takes a long time. But we should be able to start saving them up in a chest. Because right now, I'm guessing that all of them goes to basic substrate production, which goes directly into science. Here I see one. I caught it. Yeah, you know what? We will just pause the production of science for now. Or actually, let's do something like this. I want some more inserters, please. Let's leave some room on the belt for them. And now even more space in the chest. Although I don't know how many of them I will need, but probably a bunch more. Yes, for sure. Damn it. So I calculated that I needed 15 cDNA, so that means I need 75 of these incubated petri dishes. And that means also that I need 60 basic substrate, and right now I have 0. So obviously we want to fix that. So now we will save some in this chest. Actually, let's disable that inserter as well. All right, let's move up towards the Sogna bacteria again. In the meantime, we can check what else we need for this. We need plasmids. So we will need 15 plasmids, which is another... Okay, I think we have enough to make these plasmids now. Where is our biofactory? Incubator, bio, there it is. Am I blind or something? Probably. What's this? Sodium acetate, no idea what that is. Let's go with the plasmids. Right, 15 of these, you say. Sogna bacteria. Oh. Power, you say? Alright. That's them. Now for the retrovirus, which is also a big thing. Incubator. So these need hot air. And the rest of them is items. Sure. Here we have some hot air. Let's place down an incubator. Retrovirus. Holy cow. Now, of course, this might take a bit of time just to get all the hot air we need. I'm disabling this for now. Where am I? Let's change the recipe of this. And use the ordinary aluminum. Great. Have we gotten anything yet? Nope. Steel plates? Sure, that can be fixed. Glass? Okay, so we need 15 of these as well. Which means that we need 15 petri dishes. We got that. 15 laboratory instruments. 15 glassware. 15 and 60 Vrauk cocoons. I haven't checked the amount of Vrauk cocoons for quite a while, so this might be interesting. 114, nice. So let's take all of them, why not? Then let's go get some glassware. Oops. Seems like the Vrauks are still producing. So where do we have our glassware? I believe it's here somewhere. Oh, look at this, I have even saved some petri dishes. Why have I done that? I think it should be enough with 500 of these. Five. I probably saved those petri dishes because I knew I would be using them, and now is the time I need them actually. So that's some basic substrate, but I think I wanted 60 basic substrate. 15 times 4. Yes, that's 60. And I have 40 at the moment. All right, I have the glassware. I need some steel, though. No, wait, I have steel. All right. Let's take a look at our little flower DNA sample production. Thank you very much. And speaking of which, do we have more science over there? Only 33. So that will have to wait a bit longer. Because we need a few more of those for the moon drops. Or maybe I should start with the moon drops. I'm not sure. And let's see, where are we? Here we are. We have some hot air, we have cocoons, we have steel, we have glassware, we don't have any laboratory equipment with us. So let's go get that, assuming we have some. If we don't have some, I think I know what we should blame. We should blame our copper once again. Four. That's not a lot. Hi, what is missing? What is missing? Rubber. We're actually missing the rubber. Why are we missing the rubber? Because we're missing latex, because we're missing this, because we're missing this. We are missing formic acid. We are missing formic acid. Because we are missing carbon dioxide. And that's actually kind of what is missing is telling us here. We're missing carbon dioxide because we're missing biomass. When we are missing carbon dioxide, we don't have any seaweed. If we don't have any seaweed, there is actually another solution to that. One of them is to just fill it up manually with a lot of seaweed. The other one is to use a different recipe. 8 seaweed, 2 limestone. No, I think let's go for the classic old one. At least in one of these. Then maybe there will be more carbon dioxide. No, actually, let's use the old recipe in both of them. Then hopefully we shouldn't lack that much carbon dioxide. See, now the formic acid is missing iron plates. That doesn't sound right. No, it's fluid ingredient shortage. Whatever. Anyway, it's probably the other machine that's missing iron plates. That's one of the bad things about what is missing, that it's not easy to see which machine is missing it. So if you have two different production chains, then this kind of stuff happens. So, laboratory instrument, retrovirus, go. And then we need some more hot air. But this is at least a start, I think. And it seems like we need more cyanobacteria. Should be possible to fix. Okay, now cDNA. You need a gene lab. So, and you're going to need Moss gene sample, of course. So we need 75 Moss gene sample, which means we need 150 glassware and a shit ton load of moss. Very well. Hi, Moss. Or as we say in Swedish, tjena Moss. Only Swedes will get that, but that's basically one way to say hi in Swedish. Okay, glassware and moss. 100 more glassware. Or something like that. And a bunch more moss. Am I storing moss in a chest somewhere? I think I might be. If not, maybe I should start to do so. Like this. Thank you, basic substrate. I think I have enough now of what I need, so you can continue the science. Thank you, glassware. ¥140. That's okay. I might have left something in some machine somewhere. So, I guess we're moving up again. I'm going to need a shit ton more of moss. Moss, 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 moss. This is moss. Maybe it contains. Yes, it contains quite a bit of moss in the machine. Great. Thanks. One time when caching stuff in machines is actually useful. Thank you, Factorio. I don't have any underground belts, so I will just make some underground belts, even though I don't have any plans. Specific plans for using them just yet, and the same goes for inserters. And why the heck do I still have this in my quick bar? I haven't built those low quality iron pipes for maybe 30 episodes or something, I don't know. Very well. Here we are. Retrovirus. Moss. All right. Moss gene sample. Plasmids. I need 15 plasmids. I need lamp. Very interesting that lamp is a ingredient in these kinds of things, but this bacteria probably needs light in order to grow. Makes sense. I see. Interesting. Did not think about that. I might need some more petri dishes. Very well. Ten. 11. Okay. Do I have a machine for... Oh, it also requires a gene lab, I believe. Steel, iron, aluminum, duralumin. Okay. I can fix this. Assuming there actually is some duralumin here, and there is. Steel, iron, aluminum. It seems like I'm not sure where we have. Ah, here we have it. Okay. Thank you. Gene lab. Did I miss anything? Steel and seaweed. Sure. So many things. Usually in Factorio, once I've like established a good base and stuff, I build a mall, and the mall usually produces like almost every single item there is in the game. I'm not so sure if I will do that in this mod pack, considering how hugely and crazy amount of machines there are. But I guess only time will tell. Hello, Petri dish. The rest of you can actually go in there. I need seaweed and steel. And more space in my inventory. It seems. Hello, steel. All right. Gene lab. Oh, dear lord, this is the one thing that takes like eternity to create. But sure, might as well get started on it. Okay. More moss, more glass. 22 moss gene sample. We're gonna need a lot more than that. I'm going to take a look at why we are not getting enough rubber. Because I'm assuming once again that... Yeah, this... process. Well, actually, of course. Let's change the output priority here until we need onions at least, which should not be for quite a while, I realize. So rubber, how are you doing? Is it still the latex that is missing? Yes, it looks like it. It for sure looks like it, but I think it's slightly better now, actually. It's just the carbon dioxide that is missing. So let's take a look at the carbon dioxide. In the meantime, let's make a couple of more circuit boards. Carbon dioxide. Where are you being made? Are you being made there? Yes, you are. So you're powered by the Favogai plantation. Seems quite suboptimal. So let's see if maybe we can find another carbon dioxide source. For example, this one. And let's just drag this pipe up a bit. Oh, we don't have a lot of landfill. So we will have to take a little detour or something. Actually, it might not even be a detour. I'm not quite sure which the closest way is or where we are going with this. Yeah, we are going with this, apparently. What? Carbon dioxide 9k. Carbon dioxide 1.5. Water? What have we done now? Oh, damn it. We've made this mistake again, of course. Of course. We should be very careful when changing recipes in machines that require fluid. Because then it's possible that it mixes up ingredients in the pipes. Very well. How are we doing with the laboratory equipment? Do we have any more? We seem to have some at least. 4! Woohoo! Victory! Now with this little rubber that just arrived over here, we will get in 4 more. So rubber is definitely the missing part here. Oh dear. But at least we are getting it. This is definitely a step in the right direction. 7? Did I have 3 before? Oh well. Sure. We don't have a lot of iron, it seems. Okay, now what are we making? Because we need to make quite a lot of things. cDNA. Glassware. Laboratory instrument. Basic substrate. Let's see, do we have the bio sample? Do we have the bio containers? How can I not have the bio? Maybe I actually cancel that production. Okay. Or maybe I put it somewhere. Would be useful if we would have a search mod at the moment, but we've seen what happens already if we use that one, so let's not use that one. Thank you, that's biosample. So, how many? Biosamples will we need? The cDNA requires biosamples, so we're going to need 75 more biosamples. Okay, I guess we'll just get started then with making more biocontainers. Oh dear. So, incubated petri dish, basic substrates, MOS gene sample, plasmids, retrovirus, laboratory instruments, and biosample. We are making our very first cDNA. So we will have enough to make maybe a few of these. So we would need more biocontainers, so I need more to get more steel. I was hoping that we would get our 15 cDNA in this episode, but given how many different things it is that we are missing, that is starting to look very unlikely. I think we have a steel chest over here. We do. Biocontainer. Only five. We need more titanium. There we go, that's more like it. I think I said I needed 75 of them or something. So that's 20, that's 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and 5. Right. Now, Sogna bacteria, please have some petri dish and start producing yourselves. So that's some biosamples, that's another set of biosamples. We have some more plasmids. We need MOS gene sample. We need more MOS for this machine. So, biosamples and retrovirus. And retrovirus is being made here, and for retrovirus, we are missing the laboratory instrument. Oh dear Lord. Well, at least we can actually use some inserters here for some things so that we don't go completely crazy. Not that this is a very clean setup or anything, it's just that this is not something that we need to produce constantly. It's only the laboratory instrument that we definitely need to produce constantly. Because it's being used in the green science, which we haven't set up yet, but we are getting closer to it. Whew. Oh boy. What a break. Actually, I even need to refill my water, so I will be taking a short break and be back right soon. In the meantime, you can just look at the factory. Ah, that was refreshing. Now, heterovirus. Right, laboratory instruments, of course. Least we do have quite a bit of biosamples. That's a start. No. So we're going up again to take a look to see if we have gotten any more laboratory instruments, and we do. That's pretty neat. So now we should just use them, sort of. So that's one laboratory instrument for each of these heteroviruses. And I'm not completely sure how many we still need. We have four cDNAs, and we need 11 more. So that's probably nine. So I will put in a few more of these laboratory instruments, and then we just need to wait for some hot air to arrive here, and then hopefully this part should be done. Do I have any more Rao cocoons in my inventory? I do. Let's fill it up. All right, incubated petri dish seems to be the next thing missing. We have five cDNAs. This should actually be enough to make one of these Alesias. So we need a botanical nursery. Do we have that? We do. So let's make ourselves. Okay, we need some biosamples, we need some cDNAs, and we need water. Do we have water nearby? We do. Please give me water. And please give me power. Ah, we are making our very first set of Alesias. Wow. Huzzah! Now we need to make a Alesia plantation, and for that we need to have some treated wood For that we need wood and creosote. Should be quite easy. And for that we need an automated factory. Sure. Sure thing. Let's get some more incubated petri dishes. I'm so close to my goal and I'm not quite giving up just yet. That's for sure. Petri dish incubated. Here you are. Thank you. Oh, it's working, that's for sure. Okay, now it's producing one for the science. Okay, I thought the science was a bit slow, but at least it's going somewhere. Speaking of science, how are we doing with that chest? We are at 84, so that means we just need a little bit more and then we have enough to make another codex, or another DNA sample, rather. It's strange the way, I mean, if they are capable of making one DNA sample, shouldn't they just be able to replicate that somehow in an easier fashion? I don't know. Anyways, okay, it seems like we have produced quite a lot of plasmids. I'm going to take that as a good sign. Hello, incubated petri dish. So this will be our sixth cDNA that we are producing right now. That means that we need 9 more. Oh wow, we're actually almost halfway there now. So let's put in some more laboratory equipments. Then we're going to need more moss. More moss. Thank you, moss. It's huge amounts of moss we need. Okay, more biosamples, I guess. You have biosamples, what's the problem then? More moss gene samples, well, you are working on it. So what's the problem then? Nothing is the problem. cDNA. Awesome. Now let's take a look at this. We have enough of these to actually do something here. Biosample. We just need another set of biosamples and then we have the Halesias. Cool. Did I make a plantation for this? What's this? Guar bean plantation? Okay, sure. Alesia. There you are, Alesia plantation. Right, treated wood. Of course. And glass and simple circuit boards and lamps. Sure. Glass, simple circuit board, lamps. So that we need wood and we need creosote, which is created from tar. So we have a machine for that in the top. So let's go grab some wood. This is almost like a treasure hunt because of all the different things we need all the time. And there we go, we have another set of DNA sample possibilities. So why not start this process? We just need a Halesia codex, which we can't make. So alrighty then. How about we create, see if we have the possibility to create some more other things. Halesia. Right, it's the treated wood, and the treated wood is done in automated factory wood creosote. Okay, I have wood. I am on my way to get creosote. I have an automated factory. We are on track. Whew. Now let's see. Here is aromatics. Here is the creosote. I hope there is something in these pipes. There is not. We are drastically missing tar. Sadly. Treated wood. Oh well. So, how much treated wood do we need? We need 50 of it. That's quite a bit. So that's 25 of these times. Okay. Now we might start to wonder where our tar is going. And honestly, I think that's a very good question. How about we check at our production down here? It's standing still because our our shed is full. Very well. That can be easily fixed, hopefully. So the small amounts of tar we have here, those are like nothing compared to the big tar production that we get from the stone. But if you can't handle all the byproducts, then this is what happens. Hello, wood. May I borrow some of you, please? Thank you. Hello, storehouse. Hello, fast inserter. That's right, we are going to expand this storage by quite a bit. And hello, long inserter. There we go. Perfect. Now, hopefully, this should get started again. How about we also put some fast inserter over here? It's nice to experience actually that now the inserters are actually starting to be the slow part. It's never been like this before, really. So this is great to see. All right. Let's move back up again. It's entirely possible, actually, that this is the reason for why we got so low amounts of iron and stuff. Well, iron shouldn't really be a problem. Oh, the iron problem is, of course, due to the hot air. So let's change this recipe. Oh, that was a very useful shift C, thank you. Though I hope that we do not. I'm going to take some of these things back. Well, you can keep the cow cocoons probably. All right, that's another two. Biosample. I think I put five of them in here before. Oh, but actually it's seaweed that's missing. Sure, that we can easily fix. And let's see, where are you going? You should go into this one, I believe. Now, this is the last Alesia that we need. So let's take a look again at the production of the treated wood that we are going to need. We needed 50 of it, and we have more than that now, so great. Alesia. Lamp, duralumin, glass. Okay, so we mostly need duralumin and glass. And then let's start off by fixing some of these. How are we doing with the laboratory things here? 16, nice. Give me some duralumin, please. Thank you. Thank you kindly. And glass. I'm sure I have glass production somewhere. I believe. And by glass production now I mean real glass production. Like the actual item glass and not just glassware. I think I might have found it. I have. Yeah, why not take all of it? Thank you! So, can we make a Calesia plantation now? Yes, we can. Amazing! So, we are very close. We are so close. Speaking of which, I just need to take a look at. Right, I need to fill up with more Vrouks. There we go. So it's not quite finished yet with the Halesia. So let's see. We are going to need one Ralesia here to make something happen. And then we are going to make some Ralesia seeds, which we can make in the botanical nursery as soon as this is finished. Unless we have another one of these, which we actually do. So this is good. This is definitely going to speed up things. Let's just move things back and forth here. Nope, not that one. Nope, not that. Wait a minute. Oh, right. Alesia seeds. Okay, they look like this. There they are. I was worried there for a bit. More electricity. And give me some water as well, please. Right. So now I just need to put these 5 Halesias into this. And that gives us 8 seeds. And we need 5 of them to start producing something. Which gives us 4 Halesias. No, you're gotta be kidding me. Will I... No, it's enough. No. It's not enough. Because if I remove this one, it stopped. And if... So from this, I get 4 of them. I just need one more set of Halesias, because I need 5 of them to start doing something here. Oh, come on. Flower DNA sample, biosamples, 3 more seed DNA. I'm so close. I will want to finish this in this episode. I need more moss. And then I need... Do I need anything else for this? I need the Halesia Codex, a flower DNA sample, and all of that. So let's see if we can make a Halesia Codex. We cannot. We need tinplate and seaweed. Things always take longer time than you expect, but with me being this close, I'm gonna push this episode a bit longer. I'm sorry, but that's just the way it is. I mean, it's not like you expected this to be finished on time either way, did you? Oh boy, seaweed. Here we have seaweed. Great. So, Halesia Codex. And I might need... 2 of them, unless I started. I did not start this. Damn it. Oh well. So we need just another Halesia Codex. So more seaweed. Sure thing. I think I know a place or two where we can get some seaweed. Thank you, seaweed production facilities. So another Halesia Codex. And then we are going to start this one. To get the flower DNA samples. And once we have those flower DNA samples, we will be able to get our last needed Halesia production thing. Oh dear lord, this is taking time. Jesus. But once it started, I'm guessing it's going to sort of... Yeah, these seeds can explode themselves. Thought I had read that somewhere. I can only imagine. So this is currently working at a crafting speed of 0.2196. It takes 130 seconds. So that means that it's taking 10 minutes, 591 seconds. It's taking about 10 minutes for one set of these Halesias. But yeah, that's just the way it is. Biosample cDNA. We have two cDNAs, we have biosamples. So, right, we needed some more moss. And here, by the way, is the Halesia seeds. And here is an inserter that can take out the flowers later. So, moss. Thank you, moss. And then we head down and check for how that factory is doing, how the data array is processing our flowers, our dearly beloved flowers. It's halfway there. How long time is this planning to take? It's 150 seconds left, so that's 2.5 minutes. Well, seeing that we are already 12 minutes past 1 hour, I'm guessing that this is actually a good place to say thank you, and thank you for watching, and see you in the next episode, where we will hopefully explode with Ralesias and start the moondrops. See you then.